Yes, indeed, it's Near FM Sessions. Vic, take it away, my friend. What are you going to play?
Me and Silcia.
Ah, lovely.
Here we go. Oh, it was our last time together, together. Oh, it was our last time together, together. 'Cause I love her and she loves me, but now the end was near for me and Silcia. Oh, she had a lovely smile and she was always sincere, but now the end was near for me and Silcia. Was the last night forever together? Or was the last night together, together? 'Cause I love her and she loves me, but now the end was near for me and Silcia. 'Cause I love her and she loves me, but now the end was near for me and Silcia. Oh, she had a lovely smile and she was always sincere, but now the end was near for me and Silcia. 'Cause I love her and she loves me, but now the end was near for me and Silcia.
We're going to an ad break.
Okay.
Just in case you're wondering.
It's a bit of a melodramatic song.
That's very nice, yeah. Very rhythmic.
How long since you wrote that now?
Oh, a long time, that one.
Long time.
Long time ago. Does it sound old?
No, it sounds class. Class. How long have you learned?
Oh, over 15 years.
15 years. Yeah. How fine. Do you like it? Are you settling in now?
Yeah, I'm settling in, yeah.
Have you understood us now? The deal, culture, there's no culture mix
there
anymore.
There is a bit of a slight differences, but yeah, sort of keep on adapting.
You want to sync up your video recording?
I don't mind. I mean, I could always sync it myself, you know.
Well, if you are, just give us a single clap.
Okay. Press go, and I'll edit it later.
It's recording now.
Oh, it's recording?
Yeah,
oh.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
go.
It.
That's fine.
Cool.
You're recording it.
You don't want to miss this. This is the best bit.
Hopefully if I get a copy of the show, I can put it online, either the whole thing if you want.
Cool. Excellent. Like that. Like that, my friend. So
no, I always do it. I always...
Yes, indeed, it is the Near FM Sessions, as the good lady says. Vic, you're very, very welcome to the show, my friend.
Nice to meet you. How are you?
I am fantastic. How are you?
Great, mate.
Tell us, how did all this, firstly of all, you got to let the audience know because they'll hear a strange accent. Where are you from originally?
Okay, I'm born in Perth, Western Australia.
My parents are Greek background, so you're probably wondering why I've got a Greek name. So,
yes.
Vic Stathopoulos. And I was born in Australia, and I've been living in Ireland for over 15 years. Been playing music since I was a kid. I really got back into music in the last 7 or 8 years.
Right.
And really, it's the last couple of years that I've been playing music live again. Before, I used to play in a band, but now I just play live. So when I got back into music, it was around 2013. I decided at the time, you know, I wanted to play live. I sort of procrastinated, you know, a few years before that. I just stuck to the recordings. And I went to Nashville. And it was really strange because I said to myself, you know, when I go to America, I'd love to play in a, you know, in a venue or something and record a song. So I went to Nashville and I went to this place. It's called the Ryman Theatre. It's where all the famous artists up to about the 70s used to perform, like, well, you know, all the country artists. I can't think of her name. But anyway.
Dolly Parton and Tommy Wynette.
Yeah, the whole lot. They used to sing there. And so anyway, I turned up there and they had a recording studio. So I recorded a song called Lena. And that turned out really good. And while I was there, this girl really liked particularly the song. And she came over to me and she was sort of annoying me. And she goes, can you sing the song on stage? I said, there's no one in the audience, only about 6 people. She said, just sing it. I said, okay, all right, I'll go and sing it. So I was there, I got a photograph of the session, and I actually sang in the Ryman. I didn't realize what I did.
Wow.
And it was really spectacular. It was like an old wooden amphitheater, sort of really spectacular architecture. It's worth just to see the place. And I got a photo on the stage. And then near the end of the holiday, I went to the shopping center, and this lady said to me, you know, have you ever been to Tootsie's? I go, where's Tootsie's? I've heard of Tootsie's the movie, but I never heard of Tootsie's the venue in Nashville. So she says to me, oh, you should go there. So all the famous artists play there. I said, so anyway, I had it in the back of my mind. So we went in, it was the second last night before we were leaving, and we're just walking around down this. Have you ever been to Nashville? It's amazing.
No, I've never been.
It's definitely worth it. I think you can get a direct flight from Ireland, I think. I'm not too sure. And it's full of these honky-tonk bars with music, and so the atmosphere is great. You can walk around and go to different venues, and the music scene's fantastic. You don't even have to be into country music. They play rock music, they play all different sorts of music. So anyway, we went to this Tootsie's, and it was packed out. I thought, there's no chance of getting in. And someone in the door said, why don't you go to the back lane and go through that way? I said, the back lane? So anyway, we went into the back lane, and we ended up in this, the back, and there was a band playing at the back. And I asked the guy if I can sing a song, and I don't know, I waited an hour, didn't get a chance. So there was another band playing at the front, and I thought I'll ask them if I could play a song. And I thought it was the manager of the pub, but it was actually the singer of the band.
Oh.
So about half an hour later, he called me up to the stage. You know, no practice, nothing whatsoever. And he said, you want to sing a song, a country song? I said, oh, I was planning to sing one of my original songs. So I ended up singing Lena. So I got on the stage and started singing. The guy didn't even know, you know, I just played key of A, and I just grabbed the guitar. The drummer was playing along. And it went really, really well. And if you want to hear that, so if you want to see the video clip, I've actually got it on my website.
Ah, yes, I've been on your website today. It's actually a really nice website.
Thank you.
Well done with that, my friend. We do get some guests. I won't mention names, but they have a website. They say they have a website, but it's kind of like just 2 pages of bio. But your website's kind of cool.
Yeah, I've got a lot of different stuff on it. You probably noticed that.
Yeah.
I've got like different sections. I've got sections like when I play gigs, you know, I put like a gig guide, you know, how many songs I play, say 3 songs or whatever. So for example, after I play here, I'll put in the list that I played 3 songs, so you can see all the songs I've been playing the last couple of years. Then you've got another page with all the lyrics. It's not all the lyrics I've written. I've written like hundreds of songs, but there's maybe about 20-30 songs there. And then I've got I'm connected to SoundCloud, YouTube and different websites. So on SoundCloud's got certain songs. I've also got some songs in Reverb Nation. They're the ones that are not on, you know, SoundCloud. And then I've got some on YouTube and some other unknown sites, you know, just to keep a backlog of all the different songs. And so if you want to hear those songs, you can go to those websites. Plus I have songs which is just only me playing, you know, synthesizers, different type of songs, instrumentals, and you can even hear me with like a band situation. So my songs varies, but whereas here I'm just doing, you know, acoustic guitar.
Come here, let me ask you, you said you played in a band.
This is in Australia.
This is in Australia.
Yeah.
What's is it more freedom for yourself being on your own, or do you sometimes miss the band? When you're up on stage, sometimes do you go, I really wish I had a band around me?
I found it quite difficult at first playing by myself, because firstly, even forget about the performance. When you go to the venue, you've got no one to talk to.
Yeah.
You know, you sort of turn up with the guitar and, oh yeah, you get on this time and you get up and, you know, you do a couple of songs and you're off and that's it. These days, I sort of, when I go to the venues, I try to, you know, meet up people, just have a chat, a bit of a laugh, have a drink, you know what I mean? Turn it into like a night out also. But when you're on stage, you know, you play your three songs, and originally I used to find it quite stressful, you know, because I had no backing band. You know, the drums would do the bit and, you know, guitar. And if you're playing longer than, say, half an hour with acoustic, you get quite tired.
Yep.
Whereas with the band, you know, everyone plays a bit and you don't have to, especially if you're just singing and you've got the backup, you don't have to work as hard.
That's true. I suppose you can hide a little bit behind the rest of the band. You know, when it's yourself, you're kind of, it's you. That's it. You can't.
Yeah, well, in the old days, I used to play Greek music also, so I'm quite experienced in playing Greek music. I could play bouzouki also, which is a Greek instrument, 8-string instrument.
Well, is it kind of like a banjo or...?
Well, it's similar to the Irish bouzouki. I think the Irish bouzouki copied the Greek bouzouki a long time ago.
Yes.
Have you heard the Irish bouzouki?
Yes.
So it's basically the first four strings of the guitar is the same as bouzouki, but it's taken down a couple notes. So if you play a chord, say like G on the guitar, it's exactly the same as bouzouki. So if I can play the four strings on this, you can play the four strings on the bouzouki. So you don't, So you can learn it. It's not that difficult.
Cool. Tell us how much does the Greek thing influence you? Because I got some kind of lovely kind of Mediterranean vibes off that. The last song. Is it a big influence in your songwriting or?
Yeah, it depends on the song. Like if I'm writing a specific style, it might not have that much of an influence. But then other songs might. Like I've also tried to write in Greek rhythms. So the Greek rhythm sounds very foreign, you know, to Irish or to English or to Americans or Australians. Whereas other times I just play a rock and roll song, you know, when everyone sort of can get into.
Yeah.
Mesosia is sort of got that melodic, sort of European sort of style, but it's also got that sort of Spanishy.
Yes.
That guitar dang. So it's got the combination. It's quite uplifting song. Maybe the lyrics aren't uplifting, but the song's quite uplifting. When I play that song, a lot of people like that one. They always say to me, you know, play it live, you know.
It is. It's a lovely song. Can I ask, what's it about? Who's it about? Do you want to say?
Well, it's actually about a soap opera character from a TV American show called Another World. I don't think they make it anymore.
Right.
And it used to be on an Australian TV about 3 o'clock. And there used to be a character called Cilcia. Her name's not Cilcia. Her name is Cecilia.
Ah.
For some reason, I made a mistake. I got the name wrong. And just that the word means you'll see it sounded pretty cool. And I just wrote the song spontaneously, you know, pretty basic lyrics, and that's it.
So it's not about an ex-girlfriend or anything?
No, it was just about this character, you know, because she was sort of going with a lot of guys and breaking up, and I thought, you know, this is the end of the relationship with Cilcia.
Tell us, you're kind of resident now in Mud O'Reilly's.
Yeah.
Do you do that every
week or two I go in there. They have a session on Thursdays. So a lot of different artists come in and play, and it's quite fun. Do you know where it is?
I know Mud O'Reilly's very well, my friend. Frequented it many a time. I've been thrown out of it a couple of times.
Oh!
but
I just found out tonight you can actually catch a bus from up here in Coolock, number 15?
Yep.
And go straight to Mud O'Reilly's.
Right outside.
Yep.
Right beside it.
So if you go over there and have a few drinks, you can leave 11. I don't work for Mother Riley's, but just you can leave at 11:30 on a bus and come straight home up here and, you know, have a bit of the south side.
What's how do you find the Irish audience? Is it different from Australia, and what way is it kind of different?
It depends on the audience. If it's Irish audience, you know, like when I play, say, some songs, they get quite excited. Like Mil Cecilia, or you know, they might make a comment or something. And when you get the tourists sort of want to hear Irish music, you know, say if you're playing in these pubs, but the Irish more there, you know, for listening to original music. I remember I played this song called Life Is Too Short, and this guy got excited and he goes to me, can you play me Bombalero, you know, that Spanish song. Was it Gypsy Kings?
Gypsy Kings.
I thought, okay, that's interesting. I didn't know how to play it, but the other song reminded him of it, and he got really excited. So it's interesting.
We do get excited. We do. We have to be watered down sometimes if we get too excited. What was kind of like? How do you find the live music scene in Dublin at the moment? Is it still as vibrant as it was, say, 2 or 3 years ago? Is it dying down a bit, or?
I think some of the venues change. You know, there's still the scene everywhere, but some of the venues change. But the main venues are still there. I mean, Mother Riley's has gone for years. You've got other venues, say, in the centre of Dublin, you know, like International Bar, whatever. And the perfect nights for going out, you know, can have a few beers, relax, chillax, come home. And there's a lot of bands, some really, really great artists. I've seen some fantastic people. I even saw a red-headed Bob Dylan. I thought it was fantastic. It's a shame he didn't get on TV, but he could be the next Ed Sheeran, but in a folk music style.
I think we had him.
I don't remember his name.
Can't think of his name. I'll think of his name in a second. But speaking of brilliance and all things incredible,
okay,
we're going to play us another song.
Okay.
What are you going to play for us?
I'm going to play a song which I'm going to sing in Greek and in a bit of English.
Yes.
And it turns into a bit of Rocky, but I'll be singing that bit in Greek.
Go for it.
Okay, here we go. Σε βλέπω, δεν βρίσκω δημιουργία να σου πω. Έλα να χορέψουμε, γιατί σ' αγαπώ. Και λέω, έλα σ' αγαπώ, μη φεύγεις τώρα, σε θέλω. Έλα σ' αγαπώ, μη φεύγεις τώρα, σε θέλω. Cause I love to, love to listen to. Cause I love to, love to listen to. Cause I love to, love to listen to you. Cause every time I see you, I can't help myself to say, let's talk about it. Cause I love you so. Cause when you say to me that it's all over, I look at you and say, cause I love to, love to listen to. Cause I love to listen to. Cause I love to listen to you. Κάθε μέρα που σε βλέπω, δεν βρίσκω τη δύναμη να σου πω. Έλα, τι είσαι καπό, και σου λέω. Και του λέει πως θα φύγει.
Mosoris es refile, in oreos copo. Calosoris es refile, in oreos copo. Calosoris es refile, in oreos copo. Calosoris es refile, in oreos copo.
Vic, you're a breath of fresh air, my friend. You're a breath of fresh air. That is fantastic. That is fantastic stuff. What is that about?
Strange combination, isn't it? Different.
Yeah.
It's two songs. Two songs. The first song's called I Love You, and it's sung in Greek and sung in English. The two music parts are quite different, but they're sort of connected by that twangy, sort of funky, you know, that guitar bit. And then I jumped into the second song, which is sort of like a 70s sort of status quo, similar status quo beat, and then it goes straight into the Greek song. So they're both original anyway.
Love it. Vic, if people want to find out more about you and they want to come to your gigs and all that stuff, how are they going to find out more about you?
Okay, you go to website, everyone's the internet these days, www.planetvic.com. So I'll spell it just in case people get confused. It's planetvic.com, not a K but a C, vic.com. It's probably too hard to write my Greek name, so if you type Vixstathopoulos, you might not be able to spell it.
I you had to tell me how to say it there a while ago.
Or just go to SoundCloud Vic10.
Vic10.
On SoundCloud.
What's the future hold for you, man? What's coming up?
Well, I've been trying to prepare, an album, for this year, later in the year. So I've been doing a lot of recordings, and just to continue gigging and put more songs on Facebook and YouTube and whatever, and hopefully release a single, hopefully by November. So I'm planning to visit Australia later in the year. So my brother plays drums. My other brother plays music too. So we might do some recordings there.
Excellent. So. Vic, do you want to play another one live?
Yeah, sure.
What would you like to play?
We'll play one called Different from the other song. It's called Money Doesn't Grow on Trees.
Money Doesn't Grow on Trees.
Okay, here we go. Money, money, whoa, 'cause money, money doesn't grow in trees.
Listen, can I just say, and you're the first man I've ever said this to.
Yeah.
I love your fingering. It's fantastic.
Thank you.
Your fingering is absolutely. You want to see him, guy? If you, as Neil laughs his head off next door. It's like a thousand miles an hour. It's absolutely fantastic.
My chord playing.
big. I was going to say, normally what we do, we have kind of tradition.
Okay.
On the Near FM sessions, where we ask the craziest, cheesiest kind of question,
okay,
possibly, that we can ask. And when I pick it, it can be quite abstract. So what I'm going to do is, are you single, married?
Single.
Single. You are single. Perfect. Perfect. Because last time I asked this question, they were married.
Okay.
If you could pick one person, dead or alive, to spend the whole night with, including a bit of afterwards, who would it be and why?
Oh God, that's a hard question. Not sure. The first name that came in my mind was Marilyn Monroe. I'm not sure why.
Hey, it'd be the first name coming into my mind. Yeah, Marilyn.
Yeah, she's like party girl.
Yeah.
She can sing. She can act. Good entertainer.
I could see that.
And good looking.
Oh, damn right. Been an absolute pleasure, Vic. Again, just tell us the Facebook.
Yeah,
page
it's planet www.planetvic.com. You can hear my music, see videos, check my lyrics. I've even got some strange videos, like space videos.
Mm.
I've got video clips from where I played live. I'm going to put the video clip from our session here. If you want to see it, you can.
Yeah,
don't forget to come down to Mother.